We have breaking news. The House has passed the $1.9 trillion stimulus relief package. Last week it happened, and then it went to the Senate. But when the Senate made changes, it had to go back to the House. And as this notes, the House passes the $1.9 trillion COVID relief bill in a 220 to 211 vote, sending it to Biden's desk for a final signature. Not a single Republican supported the bill, and only one Democrat, Jared Golden, voted against it. Biden plans to sign on Friday, and that Friday signature timeline was confirmed by Jen Psaki, his press secretary, earlier today. And so what this means is it's done. If you've been waiting for things like the stimulus check, your unemployment, all these forms of aid for state and local governments, it's finally going to start to roll out. And that's great news. That's fantastic news. I mean, It's also interesting to see here because last time two Democrats voted against it, now only one did. But there's a lot of things to talk about here politically. One, the Republican Party, I think, made a mistake in how they approach stimulus. Zero Republicans in the House and in the Senate. Both times, zero Republicans in the House, because the House voted on it twice, supported this bill. But it has massive bipartisan support from the actual people. Look at this recent polling. It was dropped today. It asks people what they think about this package. And what it says essentially is that 75% of the people like it and only 18% of the people don't, including a majority of Republicans. Nearly 60% of Republicans, almost a supermajority of Republicans, like the Democratic stimulus package. And yet not a single one of the 200 plus Republican congresspeople and the 50 senators voted for it. Not a single one. This is what I've been talking about. This is why it's all about Dr. Seuss and Biden's dogs. Because at the end of the day, they know the people, the regular people that vote Republican, most of them actually like this package. So don't listen to any of the Republican fear-mongering. This is almost as universally popular as you're going to get a bill. Like, you can't get much more popular in a very partisan era than 75%. You just can't. So, like, one good thing about this approach is that Biden has said, when I look at bipartisanship, I'm not just going to look at how many Republicans in the House and Senate want to vote for my bill. I'm going to look at what Republican mayors and governors say, and I'm also going to look at what Republican voters say in polling. And Republicans, a lot of them, have given this the A-okay. And so the GOP needs to go back to the drawing board, because universally opposing a bill that's popular with a majority of Republicans has to be a really bad look. I also want to talk about how the fight isn't over. There's a lot of good things in this bill. There's a lot of good things in it. The $1,400 check should be $2,000, but people are going to get help. There's also money for basically a child social security, basically for a one-year pilot program at least. Every child is going to get hundreds of dollars a month, and that's going to reduce child poverty. We have a similar program in Canada. It's not just for 1 year, it's an ongoing thing that has cut child poverty significantly. And so there's a lot of good here, but don't forget what was lost. Yes, the $2,000 checks. Less people are getting checks this time. The minimum wage was lost. And so this fight isn't over. This bill is good, but a lot was given up to appease moderates like Manchin and Sinema, and there's a lot more that needs to be done. Remember this, because the fight for 15 is essential. The $15 minimum wage is essential, and it can't be forgotten just because it was cut out of this bill. And we also have to remember, and I talked about this when it was passed in the Senate, no Republicans voting for this, despite its massive popularity, should be a warning sign to Manchin and Sinema and Biden even, and all the Democrats that like the filibuster, they support it from a philosophical standpoint, that it doesn't work in this climate. Maybe the filibuster had a role 30 years ago. Maybe it did. Maybe it did. But it doesn't anymore. The Republicans will vote against policy that objectively helps people and is objectively popular with a supermajority of their base. They will do that. So, How the heck are you ever going to get 60 votes from Republicans to pass any policy, no matter how bipartisan, no matter how reasonable, no matter how based on compromise and give and take and thoughtful debate? So for anyone right now that's thinking the filibuster is reasonable, the stimulus package, the voting around it, the debate around it has shown otherwise. This is a good package. It's going to help millions, tens of millions of people, and that should be celebrated. Biden, again, I'm reluctant to give Biden a lot of kudos. He deserves at least some kudos for ushering this through a very narrow House and Senate majority. But there's a lot more that needs to be done. The fight to help the working class truly recover from COVID and from the challenges that existed before it, it's not nearly over yet. $15 an hour, crush the filibuster, ensure voting rights, because again, if the Republicans ever get power again, I'm afraid they're going to rig it so hard they'll never lose it.